Hi, I'm Keats. I'm the lead combat designer on Killer Instinct Season 2 and 3. Sitting with me, special guest from Microsoft Studios, we have James Goddard. James, say hi to the people.
Hey, everybody. And glad to be here.
Yeah, good. Good to have you in Chicago. How was your flight? How was your trip?
My flight was good. It's snowing.
Yeah, it is
right
snowing.
Right now, which is awesome. Yep. So, I'm not
awesome,
driving.
Air quotes.
Yeah. I'm not driving, so it's awesome.
Yeah. Super great. Also, on the sofa, we have Isaac Delrach. Delrach, Taurus.
You had it right the first time.
Yeah. With me, as always, he's my Garth, I think, at this point. And, of course, friend of the show, Ramon Franco, on the end. Network engineer extraordinaire, very handsome man.
Wrestling Colombian.
and he has reasonable Killer Instinct skill levels. Very reasonable. So welcome to the show, everybody. This is a real special one for us because it's been a while since we broadcasted any new content to you. And hopefully you enjoyed the Rash beta that happened a little while ago. We kind of surprised everybody with that. There was no stream for that. And I guess we're kind of surprising you with Shadow Jago as well, because he will be available to people who already own him this Friday. But before we talk more about Shadow Jago, we do have something very special in the studio from the Ultimate Source Toy Guys. James, you want to talk to us a little bit about the Shadow Jago toy we have here to show?
Oh, definitely. So, we have a little prototype here from our friends over at Ultimate Source. And we're cut in here and show you some details.
Yeah, we're good.
All right. So, first of all, the official website from Ultimate Source will go live December 9th to start pre-orders.
That's really soon.
Yeah, it's just around the corner, guys. Follow them at Ultimate Toy for all your updates. The full wave one of the figure lineup is scheduled to be available on March 2016.
Same time as Season 3 release, so it coincides.
Yep. And this is the 6-inch scaled figure based on the 3D game model that we're looking at here. And you can see just the incredible detail Ultimate Source has put into this and the love, man. I mean, this is legit.
This is still an early prototype, too. The final production run will be even better.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know about you guys. I'm pretty geeked out looking at this. Every time I see a new thing come through from Ultimate Source, I'm like, how much more legit can it get? It's the exact character. The days of looking at something and going, well, I think that's my fighting character, are gone. These guys are just nailing it. They're killing it. His upper body has full weapon-based articulation. He can hold his sword in his hand or behind his back. He comes with a customizable, removable base, which is styled after his stage.
So if you buy the other figures, you can actually put them on the other bases as well.
Yeah, that's pretty hot. For this one, we're not going to mess around with him too much removing stuff. But anyway, you can even remove his knee armor and swap it with the knee armor from the Jago figure if you get them both.
That's pretty sweet.
So, a nice little customization there. The price points on the full line will range between $24.99 and $49.99. And, guys, more exciting news to come. Just, again, follow Ultimate Toy on Twitter for all the updates from the killer guys over at Ultimate Source.
Yeah, super awesome to have them locally. They stopped by the studio a week or two ago, and we chatted them up. And we chatted them up, and they brought us the prototype figure for us to show you on the stream. And there's some really exciting surprise news coming soon. Can't spoil it, or I'll get murdered. But it's good stuff. I'm excited. You guys should be excited. Please be excited, right, Isaac?
Yes, please be excited.
Please be excited. All right. Let's get right on to it.
Oh man, we're gonna show
Shadow
you.
Shadow Jago is a real boy.
He's a real boy.
Yeah, let's do it. Full screen's totally fine. All right, are we full screen? We are full screen. Here's the old character select, and there's the old Shadow Jago. But oh, he's got a different pose. Very cool stuff. And I guess we should show his colors.
Yeah.
All right. So color one, you're all familiar with. Color two. Leave these on screen for a second each. Color three. Four.
That's my favorite one.
This one's your favorite?
Yeah.
Five.
Actually, that one's my favorite one.
No, my favorite is the comments.
Six.
That's getting pretty good.
Seven. Eight. I like this one.
Wait, don't do it. Don't do it just yet. And what do you guys think color nine's going to be? Any predictions from the stream?
He's dressed as regular Jago.
Level 50, you've grinded You've unlocked ultimate color. What could it possibly be?
He must be dressed as Vanilla Jago.
It must be.
Must let's, be. Let's We're holding it. A keytar.
Let's do it.
Oh!
Boom! Oh my god. You guys outdid yourselves in these colors.
Super
oh,
cool.
That one's my favorite.
That
one. No.
I would select yeah. it, but
no,
I cannot.
You can't have that favorite. That was my favorite already. Oh, wishy washy guy.
What's going on?
I think just all the colors are really good.
Yeah, oh, they're nice. All really good. Yeah. I can't wait to get to level 50 with them.
Yeah.
Maybe when we do some matches later, we'll play whatever colors we have unlocked. But for now, we're going with the default. And of course, you see his intro, which we've enabled from Boss Shadow Jago. Blah. What a cool dude. I bet he's a nice guy. I bet he's not that evil. Sharing is caring, after all. And he does a lot of that, which we'll get to in his instinct mode later down the line. Let me make player two playable before I forget and get yelled at for that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And let me make sure I have refill on the meters. I do. Cool. All right. Isaac?
Yeah. So,
take us on a little tour.
Yeah. So, you know, Shadow Jago. You see him right there. Basically, his walk speed is faster than Jago.
Yeah, so let's both start at the line here. Whoops. Yeah. Put your foot on the line, and we'll both walk backwards. Go. Oh, yeah, I got much farther than you. And if we put that line right in the middle of the screen, step towards me just a little bit. Whoops, I can't not dash on the stick. The stick is crazy. I'm just touching back. Okay, then just walk towards the center. Go. Yeah, so yeah. Shadow Jago walks quite a bit faster. Why does he walk faster, though? Jago, to be quite honest, can do a ton of things that Shadow Jago can't. For instance, he could cover himself with a slow fireball and walk in behind it. He can maintain plus frames while pressuring people with a variety of different moves and the threat of uppercut. These are things that Jago doesn't do super well. Jago is definitely a much higher risk flavor of Jago. Crazier offense, dirtier offense, but a lot less straightforward and less predictable. Yep. So the walk speed really helps him get into the spots he needs to get into to do stuff, especially because his dash is super weird.
And, you know, despite that his walk speed is faster, his jump is actually the same.
Yep. Identical.
Yep.
Boing, boing.
Another thing that we enabled for Shadow Jago that people are probably going to like.
Oh, yeah.
Is his taunt.
Yeah. Very cool.
Yeah, very different than Jago's, as you can clearly see.
And if you loop it, he just scoops over and over again as he steps towards you.
So Adam already kind of gave some spoilers a little earlier, but
of course,
Dark Impulse, yeah. Which is Shadow Jago's dash.
So come over to the line real quick, Ramon. I just want to do some spacing stuff. Do a forward dash from the line. That's it. He goes one unit. I'm going to do a forward dash from the line. If I can step backwards without backdashing. Oh! Yeah. That goes super far.
Yeah.
But it's also super committal. I'm in this for a very long time, and I do phase out, and I am invulnerable while I'm phased out. Throw me a fireball, please. I can dash through them if my timing is good. But if my timing's bad, I get hit. Because you don't have invincibility on startup. It's only when he's invisible that he's invincible. The backdash also is very committal and goes very far. But it is a very long backdash. You're in this for a while, and you are your backdash invulnerability is gone before you become invisible, so you can be hit out of your backdash just like any other character can. Not as crazy as it would look at first glance, but yeah, you can dash around the screen and be a jerk.
Yeah. I wonder if there's something else you could do. Maybe we can show that later.
Well, you can cancel the dash into a few things, and we'll get into most of those options later, but right now...
Let's do some.
You can cancel into throw. I'll show you that right now.
Okay.
So, dash, throw. Gotcha. We'll talk more about his throw in a little bit.
So, you know, we just went through his dash. Let's talk a little bit about his normals.
Alrighty.
So, most of his normals are the same as Jago's, as you can see. Some of those are pretty identical. But his crouch heavy punch.
Yep, do crouch heavy punch, Ramon. Mine goes like this.
Whoa, what?
So Jago's really hits right above his head. I'm going to jump at you. Wow, good job. All right, now you jump at me the same distance. I whiff.
Yeah, and maybe a little later we can show you why this move exists.
Yeah.
So no spoilers yet. So jump heavy punch is also new.
Go ahead and do Jago's jump heavy punch. That's got that one rotation. Cross me up with it. Really good move. But Shatter Jago's is crazy town. He just spins pizza cutter style. very fun to jump around with, but it has a lot more startup than Jago's version. Let's jump up and both hit it at the peak of our jump. There. Yeah, you can see Jago's comes out fast.
I don't want to interrupt or anything, but it appears this character's broken.
Oh, already? Yeah. We haven't even gotten anywhere yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stay calm.
I was just thinking that maybe I can win with him.
All we showed was that normal.
You're already in the chat saying this is broken. You're going to be probably passing out in the next 15 minutes.
You have not seen anything yet.
Take a Dramamine, sit down, buckle up.
Take three Dramamine.
So next move is his standing light kick.
Standing light kick, yeah. A little bit different than Jago's.
A little bit.
There's a reason for this one, too, and we'll come back to this in a minute here.
See, guys, this fixes everything. It rebalances the equation.
Yeah. So we kind of already shown the throw briefly, but if you want to do that throw one more time talk about it.
This throw always starts a juggle. It does not do fantastic damage on its own compared to Jago's throw. Go ahead and throw me with no cancels. Jago's throw does a nice little grip of damage, but Shadow Jago's throw, not so powerful. Always a juggle starter, though. We're going to show you a whole bunch of juggles that you can do to get started with Shadow Jago here on the stream, which I am going to fail for you repeatedly. But the first one I want to show you starter juggle is just simply jab into sweep. Oh my god, I got it the first try. I'm not going to do it again. Not a hard juggle, but for whatever reason, I'm struggling with it today. Jab into sweep gets you a nice 9% and a hard knockdown that you can start messing with people with, which is great.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So let's look at some of his command normals.
All right.
So one big difference from Jago, two big differences, is that he doesn't have neck splitter.
All right. Well, neck splitter is the overhead. Let's see that, Ramon. All right. That's gone.
Yep.
So my back hard punch is nothing.
Yeah. And he also doesn't have a double roundhouse kick.
Double roundhouse is forward hard kick. That is one of Jago's most useful things. On block, it's like +3 or +5 or something ridiculous. Super great for pressure. Shadow Jago doesn't have it.
But Shadow Jago has something else.
He does. He has a couple of the else's.
Yeah.
What do we got?
We got forward heavy kick, which is called Gatekeeper. You want to show what that kick does?
Oh, so this is a single hit push kick. And the startup of light kick actually looks a bit like it. So you can try and fake people out with this, because this is a bit more committal of a move, and if people jump it, you're going to get hit. But the really cool thing about it is you can forward dash cancel it. So if Ramon blocks this, I could try and sneak up for a throw.
This character is pretty fun.
Oh, he's broken.
So he also has another another move. So this one is called Dark Reckoning, and it's his back heavy kick.
All right, that looks like this. This is an overhead. Boom. And there's a bug we haven't fixed that I just saw. So what's special about this overhead kick? Well, first of all, you can cancel into it from any normal, which is great. And it confirms you a pretty easy combo because the hit stun is pretty long.
So what happens if you did this to a standing opponent?
Well, the same thing is supposed to happen to a crouching opponent.
Yeah.
You have to fix at some point. But if you do this to a standing opponent, they stagger.
What is stagger?
Stagger.
Yeah. So you want to explain what stagger is?
Sure. Stagger is a preview of a Season 3 mechanic that'll be coming in Season 3. If you stagger your opponent, you'll see them step back dramatically as such, and of course you can combo off of it. You have a big stagger on this, so you could even just do this a few times if you want. Very breakable.
The big question here, though, is can he be thrown?
Of course. So staggered opponents, like a wall splat, can be thrown. And that's one of the coolest things about stagger that you will see when Season 3 comes out. You can start using that now with Shadow Jago. So pretty easy to stagger people and combo into a throw. Very, very fun.
Wait, are you saying that Shadow Jago is going to introduce a preview to Season 3 mechanics?
That's correct. The stagger is a preview of Season 3. Will other characters in Season 3 be able to stagger? That's a definite maybe. it might happen. We'll see. We'll talk about it later, right? But let's just talk about Shadow Jago right now. So he's super cool.
So what can back heavy kick do to airborne?
Jump for me, Ramon. Oh, we get a down bounce off that. That's pretty nice. And of course, because you can cancel into it, you can do a nice starter juggle such as this. Throw into hard punch, into ground bounce, into sweep.
That's pretty nice looking.
Yeah. Be aware, if you are on the defense, that back hard kick on block is -3, so it is uppercut punishable from the characters that have 3-frame uppercut. It is the safest thing Shadow Jago has on offense. Everything else he has to open you up is worse than this. So you'll see a lot of button into whatever we called this move.
Dark Reckoning.
Dark Reckoning. Yeah, Dark something. Axe Kick. You'll see a lot of button into Axe Kick as offense, so, you know, this kind of thing.
Okay. So, you know, another thing that people may have noticed is the shadow UI there. So, one, that shadow is new.
You probably have never seen that word there.
Yeah, we got the new UI and stuff.
Yeah, if you've seen our post on Ultra Combo, you'd learn more about the new UI changes we've made. But there's also something there that's flashing that says Surge. What is that?
That's the Surge meter, Isaac.
Okay, tell me about Surge.
Wow. So, any special move you do with Shadow Jago, special moves only, not shadow moves, you could double tap the button to surge the move, and it uses that chunk of meter. And I'm going to show you those one by one as we go through the specials, so I'm not going to show you any just yet.
Okay. So, let's just go through his specials then.
Let's do it. Let's start.
So, his fireball, Shendokuken.
Yes. So
super fast.
This is the slowest one. This is Jab. That's the same speed as Jago's fastest fireball. Here's my fastest one. Wah! Those are super, super fast, which is an advantage because it helps check people, but it's also a disadvantage because you can't follow them. So the fastest I could follow this would be that. Go ahead and throw a slow fireball at Jago and walk behind it. Jago can cover a lot of space with a fireball covering him. Shadow Jago can't do that. So Shadow Jago's approach is a little more risky, a little less easy. Of course, you can throw these in the air. Why wouldn't you be able to? They're horizontal, so most characters can just walk right under them. Sorry, Agnos. You can get them pretty low to the ground. If you Tiger Knee them on the way up, you get this big hop afterwards, which is pretty unsafe and not great. But you do not have to wait for a fireball to be gone to throw another one. So you could actually combo two together from full screen like that. And that's a pretty good way to zone a little bit against some of the slower characters in the game and earn yourself some meter and get a little bit of damage.
So what is the surge version of this meter?
That's a great question. So I'm just going to double tap the jab version. And now I throw a second fireball up. Very easy to do. And you can see it ate the exact amount of meter for my meter as a surge would. I'm going to throw a ton of meter real quick. Oh, it refills too fast. All right. And the air one throws one down as well. These, I have to say, are not great on block. Even on hit, it's hard to get something off of them. Mash jab after you block this, Ramon. Whoops, sorry. I lose. I think he actually legit punished me there. So those are not great on block. You can't pressure with them the same way that Jago does, but if you're willing to surge and they're not crouching or they're a bigger character, stand up for me. Then you can actually get some frame advantage going. So if you're willing to spend, you can pressure a little bit more.
Okay.
I accidentally did the shadow version because I'm great.
Yep.
So shadow version throws five fireballs instead of one big one. Ramon, you want to clash this with me? Just do your shadow fireball as well? Go ahead.
Sure.
His eats all of mine. So the advantage of having five fireballs over one big one is these cover a ton of horizontal space. So Ramon, try and jump this fireball for me. It's very, very difficult, even with air mobility, to get over those if you get trapped because they are so wide. But if you were to clash with a higher priority fireball, they're just going to get eaten up. So, yeah, a little give and take there. There's an ender version of this, which is the meter ender. And I don't want to do a bunch of linkers yet, so I can't get to level 4, but it is Jago's meter ender from Endokuken.
All right, so moving on is Dark Fury. Oh. This is Shadow Jago's uppercut. So you notice a huge difference right there.
Yeah. Uppercut from there. He hits me. I'm going to get the same spacing. I whiff. This is a very vertical move. I'm going to get in a little closer. There we go, I got him. Very vertical move. The jab version hits once. The medium version hits three times. And the heavy version hits five times. Does a lot less damage than Jago's uppercut. Give me a heavy uppercut with Jago. Ouch. Compared to this, which does probably less than half of that. But it does leave a tiny bit of PD, which is nice. It's pretty good as an anti-cross-up. Like, if I sweep Jago and jump over and he does an uppercut, he'll probably whiff. Or not. There, like that. But if he does the same to me... No, jump a little later. I go straight up and I can stop the cross-up. So it's got some advantages and disadvantages again. Not necessarily better or worse than Jago's, just different.
So what happens when you surge this move?
That's a great question. I'm going to whiff surge it. Whoops, I hit the shadow version. There we go. There's a second one. So go ahead and block this, Ramon. Try to punish it. You might get caught if you're not careful, but with good timing, you should be able to punish both. The other really important thing about this, go ahead and stop blocking, is sets up a juggle. So you can get a juggle off of a surged uppercut. You have to input these right away. I can't stress this enough. You can't like throw a fireball and then decide later you want to surge it. You have to do this on startup before it hits. There's no hit confirming. Same with the uppercut. I have to do it right away. I cannot wait till like I'm gonna now. It's too late. Except for it came out. There. Yeah, so it's pretty impossible to hit confirm those. You have to kind of input them right away. Where are we on the list here?
So just, you know, his uppercuts a damage under.
Right. So
Shago doesn't really do much damage.
Yeah, Shago does not hit as hard as regular Jago either. A price he pays for being a ballistic crazy man.
Yeah. Well, we can show the shadow version, though. And this is right. Pretty awesome.
Yeah, this is a shadow cash out for juggles. And it's got some nice priority and invincibility on it and all that stuff. And we do have a starter juggle we wanted to show you, which is going to be Surge Dark Fury, medium punch, back hard kick, Shadow Dark Fury. I can do that. Sounds reasonable. Oh my god, the worst!
Adam, please.
I'm sorry. At least I landed the difficult one first try. There we go. So that cost me one surge and one bar, as you can see how far down my bar went. The most you can get in the combo is two surges and one shadow move, unless you build meter during the combo, which I'm sure some of you will have fun figuring out how to do.
So let's say you're, you know, dashing around and you push the punch button.
I don't have to do the motion, I just press punch?
Yeah, there's just press punch.
Whoa!
Whoa, what's that?
That's crazy.
That's called Dark Catastrophe.
Can I just go behind people and do it? Oh my goodness.
It's broken.
I do not get a combo off of this, though, unless I surge it. And if I do surge it, then I get a combo off of it. So it's pretty scary. But you gotta spend a lot of meter to make it scary. Good stuff.
Yeah. So next move, a lot of people are gonna be super familiar with this, with Boss Shadow Jago.
Yep.
Is Dark Drift. That's what we're calling his slide.
Notice I like the sparks on that.
Yeah, he has some really cool VFX.
That's the medium one, and then that's the heavy one. Goes super far. Crosses up like you'd expect. This is
hits low.
Pretty darn unsafe. Yeah, hits low. It's an opener and a linker. Go ahead and try and punish. This one's minus two, but so you'll counter hit me. I'm going to do medium. Whoops. Got me there. I'm going to do heavy. You should be able to get a legit punish off heavy. Yep. That hurts. And the punish display will be coming in 213, not in this in 212 with the rest of the UI updates. We had to hold it back a little bit.
So what happens when you surge this move?
Well, let me do a linker first before we get there. So yeah, you get linker version of this that trades sides. Can easily do the heavy version manual off that as well. And the ender version of this is an exchange ender. Just get that out of the way. You get some omen flavor in there, which is pretty nice. Kind of connects the two characters together because this character is like the union of Jago and Omen. You want to see the surge version? No, yeah. You don't want to see the surge version.
I kind of want to see
it. Okay, the surge version.
This is probably going to freak people out.
Probably.
Be prepared.
So if you do the surge version, you go behind. And it launches for a juggle. Pretty easy to block on reaction with a little practice, but when people are pressuring you from up front and they're just doing stuff, maybe you get tagged. Ramon blocks it every time. I don't even use this anymore, but for the first couple days, it's pretty scary. Of course, because it costs surge meter, you're also going to need to figure out how to cash out that juggle to make it worth anything at all. Very meter intensive character, as you will discover as you start playing him. Do we have a starter juggle we can show here?
We do.
With this too?
What can do we want to do?
Surge, slide, medium kick, surge Shendo Kuken, then medium kick and a ground bounce, then cash out.
Yep.
Oh boy. I can do this.
One thing you'll notice about this character
is
his combos are super cool looking.
Yeah, that cost a billion meter though.
Yeah.
For 25%. Still super great, and if you had built up some PD before that, it'd be definitely worth doing.
So, Ramon, you want to try throwing a projectile to him as he does the shadow slide?
That is the projectile invincible move, but I do think this just goes straight under Jago's fireball.
Yeah.
Throw me a Jago fireball. Yeah. Yeah, so if you have a higher up fireball.
Not the greatest example, yeah.
Yeah, if you have a higher up fireball, you're probably not going to want to throw a ton of them at this character anyway.
So go underneath Shadow Fireball?
Go ahead and try. Yep, sure does. Get right.
Poor Jago.
Poor Jago. But very unsafe on block. Yeah, that is the slide. I think that's everything about it, right?
There's a Shadow Linker version.
Right. Yep. If you remember, Boss Shadow Jago also teleported like this, but there was no effect, so he just kind of like appeared on left and right side.
Yeah.
Looks a little nicer now, a little more clean. You can see kind of the outline of him as he disappears, which is fun.
Yeah, the VFX on this character are super cool.
Yeah, I like him a lot.
So this character also has a dive kick called
what?
Dark Demise.
What?
You want to show people this move?
Sure.
This move is probably going to freak people out too.
Probably. I'm going to do the light version. Teleports up and then does the dive kick. The medium version teleports forward farther. And the heavy version goes even farther. And these will auto-correct when they cross up the opponent. Like that. And if you do them in the air, he will teleport in place with the light version, forward slightly with the medium, and forward more with the heavy.
What if you just want to dash forward and push kick button?
If you dash forward or backwards and just tap any kick, it'll automatically do this. So the only three things you can ever do out of a dash are throw, unsafe, uppercut, unsafe, or dive kick, also unsafe. As we'll show you, go ahead and block my dive kick remote. I bounce off, and I'm very punishable. So you have to be very careful with this move, because on block it is not good at all. Yeah, really, really, really bad.
You know, one thing we didn't really say is on hit, watch what happens to Jago.
It does stagger, so you can get a combo of choice off of this. Very nice.
So what's the surge version do then?
Well, that's a great question. The surge version actually attacks multiple times. So you'll see... Oh, I didn't misspace it. There we go. Got five hits off of that. And that just opens a combo a little bit more traditionally. And also, if he blocks this, it is pretty darn safe. I can pressure off this all day.
Assuming you have meter.
If I have meter. I just burned, like, way more meter than a player can have just doing that.
Yeah, with infinite shadow meter on, it looks...
Yeah, he looks really good.
Looks a little OP, but...
But yeah, while I'm pressuring people, sometimes I'll, you know, go behind them if I space it right. Here, back here. Oh, you're in the corner again. Get out of here. So yeah, something like this can... cross people up or double cross up. It's very scary if you space it right. You can do it from the air as well. So a nice one is a neutral jump and then fake behind like that, which is really fun. Or stay on the same side. Very meter intensive and does a bunch of scaling at the start of the combo, but pretty powerful if you're willing to spend on it. I spend most of my meter on this move because it's really fun.
So this move is also a linker, if you want to show that.
Oh yeah, yeah. This is a really good linker because it's got a huge amount of delay before it starts hitting. Reminds me a lot of Hisako's one where she dashes through you, and it catches people getting locked out when they're trying to break early. So if you do a slide opener, go straight into the dive kick, people get locked out on this all the time, which is fantastic.
That's probably going to be a problem for me. I like to mash breaker early.
Yeah.
Some people call it a guess breaker. It's not guessing if you're right.
Yeah, it's a read.
It's a read, yeah. So then he also has the ender version, which causes a hard knockdown.
Oh yeah, I love this one. Little Omen flavor in here too, but with a different ending.
Those Van Damme kicks.
Man. Hard knockdown is great for this character too, because he has a lot of nasty wake-up shenanigans. You know, if you start to learn to Tiger Knee this move, you can get it at a distance where it comes out really low and start appearing behind people on the ground. It's kind of tough on this monitor there like that, which is pretty gross. Yeah, lots and lots of shenanigans. Very, very fun.
So next up, we got the shadow version of this move, which is going to be fun.
Oh, yeah. I like it. The shadow version of this move tracks in a cool way. It goes pretty far, but it is not fast. Go ahead and throw me a fireball. I did that right in the startup, and I punished it, which is great. But if I was a little later than that, he would be able to block. It is not the fastest move ever. But another great thing about it is it does recapture airborne opponents if you can get all the hits to hit. So a nice little juggle you could do would be throw, button, fireball, shadow dive kick, and then just finish the combo. Which is probably the easiest thing to do. If you're just playing Shago for the first time and you want to convert throws and other juggles into something, what I really recommend you do is pick any button into fireball and then cancel that into the shadow dive kick. It is pretty easy. I think it's probably the easiest thing you can do. Spends 1 meter, gets him to the ground, so you can cash out.
So next up, we got his combat trait, which, you know, Jago had around the world. Mm-hmm. And Ramon, if you want to show that. Basically, you know, he's pushing buttons. Well, he's messed up. But he would be pushing buttons in order. What, are you doing heavy, light, medium? Or heavy, medium, light, rather? Yeah, there you go. So Shadow Jago,
I can do heavy, medium, light, or I can do light, medium, heavy, just like a woman. Or I can go in any direction I want. Heavy, medium, heavy, light, heavy, medium, light. Whatever I want to do.
That seems super OP.
But there's no bonus for completion. There's, yeah, if you complete a lap, you don't really get anything. But it's great on lockouts, Ramon. Go ahead and try and combo break. So if I get a lockout, I tend to just do this. And that's pretty good.
We call that around the underworld.
Around the underworld.
We're clever.
Yes.
Yeah. So I think that's most of his stuff, right? Like, now we can start getting into stuff like his instinct.
Yeah, that's all the basic stuff. We can definitely start talking about instinct now.
Okay, so let's activate instinct. Let's see what happens. Okay.
I'm glowing.
So on
what instinct, do I do?
Just like Jago, he gets the +2 on hit and block for most of his moves. That hasn't changed. But what happens if you teleport through an enemy or hit them with
fireball? Well, I'm almost out of instinct, but looks like I got something going on. Let me rebuild
it. Yeah, let's try that again. That looked weird.
So I teleport through, and now I'm sucking his energy away.
Oh man, what's happening?
Well, he's shackled. These are the dork shackles. Dark shackles.
Dork shackles.
Yeah. You can shackle somebody by teleporting through them or hitting them with a fireball. If I get hit, it goes away, though. Go ahead and hit me. It's gone.
So what happens when you're shackled?
Well, some bad stuff happens. I'm going to shackle him with a fireball this time. Now we're all shackled up. I'm going to do a shadow move. How about shadow fireballs? That only costs me half the usual amount of meter. And it also costs Jago half the meter. So we're sharing. It's very nice. I can do that with surge moves and just spend and spend and spend as long as we're still shackled together. But if I get hit, I lose it.
Yeah.
Normally, maybe you can get 2 surge moves and a shadow move in a combo. When shackled, you can get like 4 surge moves and a shadow move in a combo.
Yeah, you just get to go meter crazy.
Yeah, you get to
so
go
So you should
crazy.
Probably disable auto regen for meter
I
for
suppose.
Your shadow move.
You're right.
Spend some meter.
You're right. Shadow meter normal. That's what we want.
So just spend a bunch of meter.
So I'm going to just get rid of it.
Yeah. And you're still shackled.
You spent some meter, too.
Yeah. Spend some meter, Ramon.
I don't lose any. Shackle's a one-way thing. I don't lose anything.
So you're going to have to wait until you get instinct again.
Yeah.
But what happens when you press, you know, heavy punch and heavy kick while in instinct?
Well, we got him shackled. Have to have him shackled first. Then we hit this. Boom. We both get a meter.
Well, what happened to... What,
we both get a meter. So I'm going to spend it down again. And boom, both get a meter. So if you're feeling like you've shackled them, but you don't have enough meter to make use of it, just do that. And you can give yourselves both a meter, and you'll have a lot to spend. And you can go crazy town happy times.
It looks kind of punishable.
Oh yeah, it is. You got to find a good spot to do it. I haven't found any combos in which I can do it yet, but I bet they exist. I challenge you guys to find combos where you can do that.
We call that dark gift.
Dark gift. Everything's dark with the sky.
Yeah.
It's so moody.
Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of but wait, there's more.
Wait,
so
what?
Please.
Hold on. Wait, there's a bonus juggle in here.
Yeah. Please be excited.
You want me to do this bonus juggle? What do I have to do here?
Oh, for this juggle?
Yeah.
Oh, man, this juggle is insane.
Okay.
So you got to activate instinct.
All right.
You're going to dash through to get shackles.
Okay.
You're going to cross up and do the
dark
uppercut.
Surge, yeah.
Yep. And then you're going to do a medium kick.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to surge your fireball.
I got this.
You're going to do a forward heavy kick. This is insane. I'm not even going to read all of this. There's like 6 more things he's going to do. This character is definitely one of the characters...
First try, baby!
That wasn't even the full combo, was it?
That was the full combo.
I do not think
that was
the
it.
Full combo. I don't think it
that was. That was it.
I'm pretty sure you're lying.
Hey, Dave, how's the broken meter going? That didn't tick the broken meter.
Shackled.
Try harder.
Shackled.
Oh, there's more.
So we were starting to even out. People were defending not broken.
Okay.
Shackled tipped everyone against us.
All
right. So there's just one little comment about Shadow Jago is if you are a combo specialist, you're gonna love this character.
Oh yeah, just tons to find.
Crazy combos.
Yeah.
But there's
setups
more.
Too.
Yeah. But there's more.
Oh.
What else can he do?
So we got another special instinct feature with this guy. He has basically, I guess you would say, a special move he can only do while in instinct. And the input for that is quarter circle forward, light punch plus light kick, so quarter circle forward throw. This uses up all your instinct. I'm going to go ahead and whiff this first so you can see it use my instinct. All my instinct's gone. So this is an all or nothing proposition here. Should you hit somebody with this, and this is a grab, so if they jump it, they won't get hit, but if you hit somebody with this, Boom! This move is called Annihilation. And look at the damage. Ooh, brutal. 48%.
So do you always get 48%?
You don't, actually. Okay. Great question. The amount of instinct you have left when you activate this changes the amount of damage it does. So if you were to waste your entire instinct time on this and this only, big unbreakable damage. Very, very great as a big punish. This move has no invincibility, but it does have throw invincibility. I'm going to do it with very little instinct left. See how much damage it does. You can already tell, not a lot.
Yeah. Was that 15% or something?
Yeah, I think it's like 13. Yeah, 13. Not a great use of it. Very, very, very fun to hit people with. If you're feeling like you can't get the shackles on, you can't get a good juggle going with that, maybe you look for an opportunity to hit this instead. It's a little easier. Maybe you look for a big punish with this to end the game. Very, very good.
Yeah, it's also worth noting you cannot combo into this.
Right.
Even off of stagger.
Even though it's a throw and you can combo into throws off stagger, you can definitely not combo into this. It's a special kind of throw. Won't grab him. So you gotta hit it raw.
All right, so let's show off the ultra.
Okay. Whoops.
Maybe James wants to add some insight to the Ultra. This is his brainchild.
And the Ultra input is the same as Jago's. It's Dragon Punch, three punches. I'm going to go ahead and just do it. This is a sick Ultra.
I think that was my favorite part.
Yeah, I love the rhythm of it, too.
Yeah. James, you want to talk about
this? More!
Sure, I'll talk about the Ultra real fast.
Oh, I missed that.
So a little bit of the development of Ultra. We've all taken a stab at different Ultras.
Yep.
And worked on them. And one of the things we did with this one is we just made sure it was really more about the rhythm. The previous Ultras that I've done, like Maya's and Conra's, TJ's, have been more about like flare and like, you know, juggles and maybe not that great on the rhythm. Whereas the guys really pushed me, challenged me hard to actually work with rhythm for once, which... check it out.
It's more memorable.
So yeah, and it's definitely more memorable. And what was awesome is you know, getting the air fireballs and everything in there, and just getting his style, getting that in your face attitude. I mean, he does a taunt that like in the middle just hits you in your guts.
Yeah,
he's just like
sort of an onion flare.
Yeah, so it was really fun. I mean, hopefully everybody likes it. And yeah, definitely one of the crazier ultras in the game.
Definitely very, very fun. So wait, there's more.
Is there?
There's still more?
I guess we're going to have to go into actual gameplay to show you.
Yes.
Yeah.
So there's one more thing.
Yes, there is.
And
should
I'm not...
Before we do this, should we take a full screen camera and take some questions? You want to show us first?
If you want. Hey, it's up to you, Mr. Director. Producer.
Producer?
Director. Whatever. It's all the same.
He's everything.
He's everything.
Why are you in...
I don't know. I'm just mashing. Get me out of here.
So I guess one thing that we can mention while we're on this screen is Shadow Jago does have a shadow.
Yes.
So you can create Shadow Jago shadow.
He's got chains and stuff too.
Say that three times fast.
But yeah, so there is that. I'm not saying that three times.
So ask them, I don't know if they can hear me. Ask them to give you some questions right now.
Yeah, if you guys have some questions, we will take them now before we show you the last thing and do some matches. Yeah. Question me up, and director producer Dave Lang will.
We call him associate producer. Dave
associate producer Dave Lang will pass the questions on to us, and we'll hit them for you.
Can you explain the shackle? Oh no, can you explain two things? Go over the surge meter. There's nuts and bolts of the surge meter.
Okay, surge meter. They want to know how surge meter works once again. If you want to surge a special move, you just double tap the button. So if you did quarter circle forward punch for a fireball, you quarter circle forward punch. Just double tap it, and you'll surge the move, and it costs that little block of meter.
Yeah, if you are a person that likes to mash buttons, this will catch you off guard for sure. Yeah, you may have to learn to push your buttons with a lot more.
A little more deliberate.
I may quadruple tap every day.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, random select game of Shadow Jago stage.
Is a dive kick a full recapture?
The Shadow dive kick will recapture. Only the shadow version of the dive kick recaptures. The question was, is dive kick a full recapture? Yeah, I don't know what a half recapture is, But the shadow dive kick will recapture. The regular dive kick will not.
And the shadow version, you have to land all the hits.
Yeah, you have to.
You got to land the last hit.
Not all the hits. That's true.
That's the important.
That's a good correction.
Does Shadow Jago have, like, how many colors? How many accessories?
I actually don't know what's going on with accessories, but I know he has 9 colors.
He has the nine colors.
Yep. So that's the answer. It's just he has 9 colors.
He has 9 colors. Yes.
The reason we put dive kick in the game because we get a quarter every time someone does a dive kick.
Shadow Jago already had a dive kick before Irgon Galaxy worked on this game. So, no, yes. We did not put the dive kick in the game because we get a quarter every time somebody says the word dive kick.
I almost named the move Death from Above, but Adam told me not to do it.
Do you know what happens if you've already got a level 50 Shadow Jago?
I don't know. Maybe you just get all the colors? I have no idea. It's a great question.
I'm pretty sure the levels are based on the actual character, and you're playing Jago. Yes. You're not playing Shadow Jago.
Yes, I think so that's
everyone that's
true.
Been using the Shadow Jago skin has been using Jago.
What's the deal with Isaac Sue?
what are you talking about? Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's Onesie Wednesday at Irgon Galaxy.
Onesie Wednesday.
Yeah, playable Fridays and Wednesday.
All right, let's go back in. I'm set up here. All right, there's one more thing, guys. It's pretty ultimate, wouldn't you say? All right,
can we zoom into Adam's face when he says that?
Yeah, no, we can't.
Aww.
There's no zooming.
Oh, man.
Have to run up.
Yeah.
So, I showed you the Ultra already, and we can't show you the ultimate in training mode because to do the ultimate you must be on your first life bar. Your life bar must be green to do this. So you cannot do this at the end of every match. You're gonna have to earn it. But when you do, it's super special because supreme victorying somebody and getting a reward for it is pretty sweet. So let me just take a little more of his life down. The input is the same as the annihilation move from Instinct. It's core circle forward throw. But you just start your combo and instead of an ultra, boom. And this is a hugely enhanced version. Lots more hits, lots more damage. Big slice, and then a huge final cut at the end. Yeah! We get a cool new end pose, and it says ultimate on the screen. And I got an achievement!
Look at that.
Yeah, boom! Dave told me never say yeah boy again.
That was yesterday.
So that's the ultimate. You do it where you would do an ultra, but only if you're in Supreme Victory.
So is that indeed an ultimate?
That is indeed an ultimate.
Does that mean everyone is
terrible? So the questions were, is that an ultimate? The answer is yes. And then the other question is, does that mean ultimates are confirmed for everyone in Season 3? James, why don't you take this one?
Shadow Jago is the only character with an ultimate.
There you have it.
From the books.
Shadow Jago is the only man with an ultimate in this video game. But it is really cool, and you should enjoy doing it to people. And it works on every stage. We just happen to get this stage. but as you notice, the darkness oozes out of him, and you can do this on any stage in the game, so you don't have to worry about not getting the opportunity to do this or forcing yourself to only play on this one stage. Oh, man. Okay, should we play a match? Let's not do it on this stage, though.
I've seen a lot of requests for Spinal Glacius Sidero.
He has a spinal. He can play that, and then I can do Sidira or Glacius if we want to switch roles after this.
I can do Saberwolf.
The oft-requested Saberwolf. People are like, yeah, I can't wait to see him wear Saberwolf.
Followed up by I can do TJ.
There you go. Everybody's favorite character. Let's go.
Ramon and I have played this matchup a lot. So, oh my god. You gotta be kidding me, Ramon. I'm out of here. Oh no! And there's, you can see some of our new UI in action here as I get wrecked.
So that
Leave
was
me
the
alone.
Medium.
Leave me alone, Ramon.
Yeah, this new UI, so, you know, I'm not sure if people remember, but I used to do some commentary every now and then, and this makes this game super, super easy for commentary now, because you actually know what people were trying to break, what things the person actually did, when things are a punish, soon when things are a punish, you know, when things are also a reversal, like you said.
I don't know if
you
noticed, but that shadow counter took half meter.
Yeah, and you'll see right
uppercut.
There.
Oh my god, why would he have
the countdown for that lockout? It tells you exactly when that's going to end. for both the person that's doing it and for the person that's, you know, in the movie. Super, super useful.
Nice. Airbreaker.
We've played this match a lot. Rough.
Oh, teleporting madness. Oh, that was just...
Oh, no.
That was just mean.
It's all mean. It's all very mean.
I love how we're getting some more juggly-type characters in. That's a really nice, you know... I know a lot of people have been asking for that, so... It's nice to see us pushing more.
I don't know what happened there, but...
Yeah, he got over my head, and I attacked the wrong way.
I know, but you guys, I can't wait to see the crazy in-the-lab combo videos that come out with this guy.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I already can see people probably in the chat. We have quite a few of our lab artists that are just thinking of the possibilities. Like, he just has really awesome combos. Super creative, super fun to do.
Oh, Ramon.
I mean,
I
can't even do awesome combos with this guy. I found some really good ones, but I was really surprised.
Oh, man. So I hope you enjoyed seeing the ultimate, because I'm never going to be able to land it again. I have no chance.
How did that happen?
What?
Hey,
what can you do?
So once again, Adam has created an OP character that he cannot win.
That I can't win.
Who knew?
Oh, why'd you block that? Don't block that anymore. Oh, here we go.
Oh, you just got the spacing wrong.
Oh,
he let me back dash a lot more than
book the light manual.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. Ramon was too good.
He's just mashing light because he's scared of throws. Ramon's not legit.
So I guess one question, we actually didn't show this. So let's say Ramon was in the corner and you did his dash forward. What happens?
Ah! I can get behind him, but it takes till the end of the animation. Okay. He's not going to let me show you that.
Yeah.
He's going to run around like a crazy person. I'm gonna be unable to punish teleports. Whoops. Ah, gotcha. Oh yeah.
Looks like he should have broke medium.
Oh no.
Yeah. That's the best part.
I did not have enough medium for Shadow.
Chime in.
And he broke that.
Tell you
oh
what
my
you
god,
wrong.
Ramon, you're the worst.
Yeah. No, this is super awesome for commentary for sure. I'm sure you know people like Seijan are definitely loving this.
Well, the previous meter system had information in there.
Yeah.
You knew if you broke the wrong strength or not. Mm-hmm. You knew if you broke the wrong timing or not. But now it's just crystal clear.
I'm gonna miss. Oh, I got him! That does no damage. That was the end.
Yeah.
Oh.
That was poor damage. That's cool, though. I'll take it.
Like 13%.
Okay. Yeah, he did it at the end of his instant.
I like that damage. That's good.
Oh,
that was some nice zoning.
Oh, we got him.
No.
Oh
no, Ramon, don't break it.
I could have got the ultimate if he had tried to break there.
Yeah.
He did not.
We almost saw it.
Yeah, the ultimate is not going to be a thing you see very, very often. And when people do land it, you definitely know they do. They earned it for sure. It's definitely one of those more skill-based end match victories, which is really cool to have in this game.
Oh yeah, let's do it. And his Ultra Ender is Jago's. He didn't get a new one of those. No! 1-1.
One.
Who do we have? We've got TJ. We've got Wolf.
What
do you have? Isaac. Who do you have?
Isaac only plays TJ.
I have TJ. Yeah. I have a really good Shadow Jago too. Just I'm not ready to reveal him yet. I don't think people are ready.
Oh my god. I don't know.
The actual Shadow... the boss Shadow Jago? No, it does not. That is still the same. You get to him the same way.
Oh, come on, Ramon.
Yeah, so if you still want to fight that old guy, you definitely still can do it.
Do the same... You know, unlock him the same way, or get to him the same way. It's the same AI.
Yep.
No change.
Yeah, I picked a different color, actually.
We may not have it unlocked.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I'll play whatever we have in mind, for sure.
Although we have some cash gold, yep. We could just unlock them right away, which is super convenient.
Gotta get some cash. Yes. He just ate my backdash alive.
Oh!
And I went for the Chicago punish. Oh, he broke my manual again, because he knows I'm not comfortable on his television.
Wow, are you complaining about input delay?
You know it.
Monitor?
You know it. All day. All day, every day.
Slide. Okay, you are on a Vizio, so I guess.
That's a fine TV.
Yeah. Wait, Ramona's on the same one.
Oh my god, I got him.
Ramon's just more dabbing.
Yeah. No. I see.
Ah! Leave me alone, Ramon.
I think he's gonna go for.
Oh, I want it so bad.
Oh,
oh man.
I guess I'm sorry. I'm sorry, stream. I'm trying.
You could at least go for a stage ultra.
I could.
Oh man, he almost had it. Oh. Try to go for the
grab me out of the throw. Uppercut. Surge uppercut. Oh.
Yeah,
if I didn't light fireball there, I could have got it.
Here you go, James.
Well, there's the proof. Shago OP.
Yeah.
Ruan and I used to run long sets of these two characters, actually, and we usually ended up somewhere pretty close to even.
Yeah.
Like, the scores at first to 10 would be 10 to 8 or something ridiculous like that. Super, super close matches. Really fun.
Oh, it's explained. Spinal is still more brutal.
Oh! Okay, I gotta pick this guy over here. Let's see. Yeah, we got color 3 and color 4. What do you want me to play? I don't have 5 yet. Should I do 3? Alright, I'll do 3. Thanks for the feedback, guys.
Yeah, no.
You were talking to us. I thought you were talking to the stream.
I don't know. I can't read the chat.
I'm sure
they
said 2
first.
Yeah.
Color 2, Adam!
I already played color 2.
Alright, so we haven't had this fight.
No.
Much at all.
We did once when this character was super incomplete. Yeah. He was much more powerful then.
Alright.
Yeah, show the intro. Yeah. I'm so powerful, I can just get rid of this excess energy. I don't even care about it.
I like that he's so evil, but he had time to dye his hair yellow.
You gonna run at me? You gonna run at me? Slide. Ah, I knew it. Oh, here we go.
That wasn't good for me.
Has any of the other on-screen stuff shown yet, Adam?
Yeah, I've seen reversal, and the lockout stuff is all there.
Yep. Yeah, the only thing that's not in this one is punishment, which
will
be
goodness.
In 213.
Oh wow, I got got. Oh, I'm getting got for big times here.
Woo!
So this is
the first time people are seeing all of this new UI live.
Yeah.
So I'm curious what the stream chat is thinking about that. Do you guys like it? How do you feel?
That was a timing mistake.
I mean, it looks the same as the old UI, just more information, right?
Yeah.
The combo breakers just tell you a little bit more. There's no, like, extra stuff hanging out on the screen. It's only there briefly when it used to always be there.
Yep.
So, not much has changed. Oh my goodness, James, please. Please.
He does not want to get ultimated.
That is kind of the goal when facing Jago.
Yeah.
Don't get ultimate.
Got him!
Oh, yeah,
I was 48%. Oh, I have throw immune.
Yeah.
It's not invincible to anything except for throws. That's why you got God.
Oh, nice.
It happens.
Woo! Is he gonna do a stage alter?
Nope. I did the regular one.
Wow. That was disappointing.
Was I even in the right spot? I think I was too far left.
I think
you gotta be in the center.
I think you're
fine. You know, it didn't even occur to me that you can wake up and do that.
I'm crazy.
I was like throw.
So I'm playing a crazy person character.
That beat my throw. I beat my throw.
Gotta do crazy stuff sometimes. Oh, ran out of KV.
You got a little mashy.
Ah! Gotcha. I should've got meter. I should do more meter under with this character. Gotcha.
Yeah, you spend a lot of meter with him too.
I know. You have to. That's what he does. Ah! Oh my goodness. There. Level 1 meter ender. You happy, Isaac?
No.
Hello. Oh, he got
nice.
Me. He got me good.
Good reaction there.
Oh no, he got me good again.
Yes.
Aww. Powerful teleporting magic. Uppercut. Yeah. That only worked because he stuck out a limb.
Oh, just do that. Jerk.
Uh-oh. Oh, I'll do it again. Oh, he got me. Okay. Oh, no.
Oh, no. You mistimed it.
Yes, I did. Oh, no. James, please. They want us to the ultimate. Ah! I'm never going to hit it.
I've saved my honor.
Happen.
Can I punish?
Oh, you got it.
Yep, got it.
You got it. I'm good.
Thank you. Look, I'm one pixel away from an ultimate. Damn it.
Stole it from you twice.
Damn it.
Oh, man. I haven't played Adam.
Here's the excuses. Yeah. Here come the excuses. Isaac hasn't played this game in a year. He's still going to beat me on stream because he always does.
Yeah, my record is... Is this still flawless?
It's pretty close to flawless. You're pretty amazing.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Whoa.
Guys, the one with the...
The autobrush change?
Yeah.
Is that what you're talking about?
Yes.
Yes.
What else am I talking Franco, about? Ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Of the show.
Wow.
So yeah, that burf that he got? Yeah.
You're talking about the new autobrush,
yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing there is to talk about.
Yeah.
Those.
I really like his auto barrage under the
advantage.
Yeah, that one's really
it's
cool.
Pretty useful.
Oh, this color is pretty awesome on Shadow Jago.
Wow! Ow! Just power line. That's all you have to do.
Whoa. Oh my god. Whoa, power line.
Crap.
Of course you're gonna get hit by that.
Aw, crap.
Whoa. What?
Whoa.
What?
Oh, no. Oh yeah, here we go.
Oh, this is gonna hurt now.
I'm all about it. Oh, crap.
That one.
You got me.
So nasty.
Oh, you got me.
Oh,
no.
Yeah.
No supreme for me.
I still got it.
I can just straight up lose this.
That's a great way to end the stream.
Got him. Oh, he got me. Uh-oh.
Classic.
That was pretty classic. Oh my goodness, Isaac, please leave me alone.
Oh, I'm good. Oh, I'm good. No!
Oh wow.
I'm so scared. You're on my power line. I just do that. I did get some free damage though, that's fine.
Free damage. Oh no.
Oof.
No, I gotta tether him.
Oh.
Okay, here we go. I'm gonna tether mid combo here. That way and he breaks me, of course. I can't show off anything good.
Oh,
punch the roll.
No!
He got out. No! Ooh, good block.
I didn't block it, though.
Your breaks are incredible. What is going on? No! After I compromise with them, you're supposed to keep breaking.
Oh, my god. It's the classic.
Wake up, roll in the throw. What is this, CDS2? Oh. That was so grimy.
I love it.
So grimy. Well, TJ's OP. Confirmed. Best character.
Oh yeah, I saw some of the beatdowns. Dude's super good. Oh, okay. I think you go for late. Wow, that was supposed to be a roll. Let me just
sit there and take a fireball to the face.
Oh, I gotta stop doing that. That's not a good strat. Oh, wow. Just does light tremor right there. Oh my goodness, Isaac, you're crazy. I'm done.
I pushed it. Yeah, everybody heard it.
Oh no!
Wow.
That hurt really bad.
Oh man, if I did, if I had just done a different one.
Oh my god, your guesses are ridiculous.
They're not guesses, man.
They're super guesses.
They're not guesses if I've been right this entire time.
They're super guesses.
That's what I say.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm done. I'm done. I can't beat Isaac on the stream. It's impossible.
You really are breaking up the main board.
Yeah, I messed up.
You're unbeatable on stream. I can't do it.
Oh, I just... I got wrecked.
Oh, that's a nice combo.
Oh my god.
Isaac.
He is...
Isaac. Wow.
He's so good. He just knows.
No!
I didn't need to do that! No, I hit the wrong button!
Oh, I got him.
Oh, gets me every time. Damn it, no!
This is your
It's okay, it's okay. Woo! I'm coming back. Woo! I can't believe I dropped that. Oh.
Oh boy.
Oh no, it was heavy.
I can't cash it out. I don't have enough. Please leave me alone, Isaac.
Oh,
got him. See, Isaac hasn't played in a while, so that works.
Yeah.
That's the work I'm on at all.
Well, it's because I rolled.
Whew. Could have won that.
I could have won that. I dropped the ball.
One out of Rod. Oh. Party over.
Oh, Adam has me red. This is it.
No, I don't have you red. Oh god.
Oh, I don't know why I thought I could get that to you.
I really like light slide as a fake out as well. I actually do this a lot in a lot of matchups that I'm as scary as DJ.
Oh, how'd you know? Oh, crap.
Oh my god, Isaac, please. Oh no. No. Leave me alone. Don't step on me now. Well, this is bad news. Bad news bears.
Oh god. Wow.
Oh,
TJ.
Take my whip punish.
No.
It wasn't worth my instinct, but whatever. I want him dead.
It was worth it. Now you have no instinct, it's fine.
But I got all the meters. Oh crap.
Oh, I did not want to do up a kick. Stick and foot there. Oh, he knows. He just knows.
Mr. Oxford.
Yeah, he. Oh.
No!
Oh, I'm done. I'm done.
Oh, he's not. He got the guess break.
That wasn't a guess. It's okay. I'm coming back.
It's over.
No.
It's over. You're done.
Coming back.
I got too much life left.
God damn it!
Oh no!
Ah, I pushed it! No! Alright. So,
GG!
I was told to let Shadow Jago win.
The streak is over! Isaac can't beat me on stream anymore. All it took was him not playing for an entire year.
Yeah.
Well, that was fun.
That was fun.
Well, a couple little last minute things. Shadow Jago. Shadow Jago, he comes out. If you already own him, so you either got him with the day one bundle, sorry, or you got him with the community bundle. Shadow Jago, Friday. That's December 4th. So if you already got him, you already have him on your character select screen, but he's just a Jago clone, you're done. You don't have to do anything else. This Friday, you'll get a patch, 2.12. It'll have the new UI stuff. It'll have your brand new boy, Shadow Jago. You can explore him and have a great time in training mode. Please send me all your cool videos, your combos and setups. I can't wait to see them. Super excited. Secondly, if you don't own Shadow Jago already, you will be able to buy him again for a limited time. We're not sure on pricing yet, but that will be from December 18th to January 15th. So you have a full month to go ahead and grab him. I have been asked a few times about tournaments, like what if tournaments don't have the character? Please feel free to contact at CEO Jabali on Twitter, and we will do our best to get any reputable or even small tournament Shadow Jago codes to make sure you guys have the characters you need to compete. So don't worry about that. We're going to take care of you.
We got you.
And yeah, that's Shadow Jago. Yay! Yay! So I want to say thanks to my panel once again. I'm Keats. This is James Goddard from Microsoft. Thanks for coming in and helping out today. Yep. What do you think of the Shadow Jago?
Oh, man. You guys have just killed it.
BS, I mean, right? Super OP?
No, man. You know it's too early to tell. Yeah.
It is. It's always too early to tell.
I mean, it's not OP until, like, there's no other counter, right?
Right. So,
but, man, I just got to say, you guys did a really good job on him. And I want to thank you to the community for that incredible tournament fundraising last...
Unbelievable.
You know, last, what was it, April?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you guys helped make this extra work possible. You know, we all promised you that we would... If we hit our max goal, do something, you know, give him his move set. Well, the team went above and beyond that. That's more than what was promised.
So yeah.
Thank you guys. Thank you, the community.
The community went above and beyond too, because I mean, how many days did it take? Three days?
Yeah. 3 days.
That's absolutely insane.
Amazing.
Yeah, you guys are awesome.
Gotta thank Isaac for being on the sofa with us and walking us through the Shadow Jago outline so we could see all the moves and not miss anything.
Yep.
And
some of those bullet points included the word just wow. Just so you guys know. There's a bullet point that says wow.
He's not lying.
Yeah. Confirmed.
Yeah, I think that was on the season 3 stagger preview.
Yes.
Yeah. Stagger's pretty sweet. And Ramon, friend of the show, thanks for being here. Thanks for losing on stream with your spinal. we love you, buddy. Mm-hmm. And that was the tender moments. Thank you for joining us. Killer Instinct, Shadow Jago this Friday. We'll see you guys soon.
See you.
That's it.